open an image in Affinity Photo, and I want this area to be nice and sharp, this area all around here to be blurred. So how can I do that? Well, I go to Layer and New Live Filter Layer and Blur and Gaussian Blur. You could use another blur as well, of course. Now I'm going to go for Radius. I'm going to make it quite blurry, so I'm just going to push it to about 37, 38. And also I'm going to set Preserve Alpha to be on. So that's set and that's at 37.3. I'm not going to change anything else. I'm just going to close that now. Now if I bring over here the layers, you can see the layers here. And you can go to the actual Gaussian blur. I'm just going to go to there and I'm going to add a gradient to that. So over here, the gradient tool, there's the gradient tool. Select that. And you've got some options here at the top. You've got fill and also got none there. I'm going to go for radial because I want that central part to be nice and sharp. And I'm just going to apply a gradient now. And that's just the default gradient, this grey white one. Click there. Well, what I want this to be blurred, this to be sharp. So I'm just going to go over here and set that to black. So just set that one to be black. And you can see now straight away that it's very sharp. And also you can click there for the grey. And I'm going to set that to solid white. So that's now all done. So you've got that great sharp image of that house at the centre. And you've got the edge all nicely blurred. And you can change it at any point. Of course, you can always go to the gradient. It's still there to edit. And of course, if you come back to it later, say you do some more work, go back there. And you decide, you know what, let's go back and change it. I don't want that anymore. You just click there and then go to the gradient tool again. And now apply it again. Now, trouble is it defaults back to its raw state. So you just have to quickly change it again. Again, go to radial. Again, go there, click there, make certain it's obviously swapped away. Always the wrong way around. But you can always quickly reverse it. So gradient, reverse, and you can see straight away you can get that back again. And that's it. And of course you've got it there, and you can always then go to the background and manipulate it, do other things as well. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.